Hello, my name is George Turner, Chief of Police of the Atlanta Police Department. I'm a father of four, a grandfather of seven. I'm an LGBT ally and honored to support the It Gets Better project. All teenagers go through an awkward phase, but it can be especially daunting if you are someone who is unsure of your sexuality and where your life may be heading. You may feel like life will never get better, but believe me, it will. Perhaps you're being bullied and don't know where to turn. As a police force, we will stand up for you. No one deserves to be bullied for any reason. Talk to someone you trust, a police officer, a school counselor, or reach out to a supportive organization such as PFLAG. Before you know it, time will pass and each day you will feel better. We have several LGBT officers and high-ranking command staff here in the Atlanta Police Department who are doing outstanding work for the citizens of our city. I am proud of them because they are confident in their work and certain of who they are. And one day you will be too. It does get better.
I'm Deputy Chief Renee Probst.
I am Captain Henrietta Smith with the Atlanta Police Department.
I'm Lieutenant Brent Sherbaum with the Atlanta Police Department.
I'm Senior Patrol Officer Jermaine Chester.
I'm Officer Christopher Blaise with the Atlanta Police Department.
I'm Sergeant Carla Baldini.
I'm Officer Alicia Turner.
I'm Officer Eric King.
I'm Officer Andy Cameron.
My name is Officer John Heath.
My name is Officer Candace Hollis.
My name is Detective Donna Reith with the Atlanta Police Department.
I'm Sergeant Joe DeAndrea.
I'm Officer Nasira Johnson, and it does get better.
I think becoming a police officer sort of chose me. As far back as I can remember, I've always had an interest in law enforcement. I spend a lot of time dealing with victims of crime, particularly bias and hate crimes that are specific to the LGBT community. I work with Homeland Security in assigning whether or not it's been a bias crime or a hate crime and following up with those victims.
The best part about being a police officer to me is being able to engage people on a daily basis. As the LGBT liaison, I'm kind of the go-between between the department and the citizens.
I decided I wanted to be a police officer because I wanted to do something to help people.
The best part about being a police officer is, number one, being able to be myself in this city. You become a counselor as a police officer. You are a person that helps to provide advice for people.
Well, I wanted to be a police officer since I was a kid. Most little girls were playing with Barbie dolls, and I was begging my mom to buy me the little cop sets, and just one of those childhood dreams.
I basically went on Google, and I actually remember typing in gay-friendly police departments.
I applied to various police departments, and I remember my recruiter, I point-blank asked him, and do they hire gay, lesbian officers? And he said, we hire the best qualified candidates.
I never dreamed in a million years that I would actually become a police officer or that I could be openly gay on a police department. We get to participate in the Pride Parade. We're one of the few departments in the United States that is able to do that.
I have a great picture of the very first time we were ever in a parade, and it's a small pickup truck with three of us on board. Now we can't fit us on a pickup truck, and we actually take to the streets to walk.
It felt good being able to walk down Peachtree Street with other police officers that were comfortable being able to do that.
When I actually walked in the parade, it was very liberating.
I come from a family of about eight of us in a family. There's five girls. There's three of us that are gay. It was kind of like, don't say anything, but we still love you for who you are, and we know deep down, but I've never once talked to my mom and sat down with her and said, Mom, I'm gay. Dad, I'm gay. They just knew.
I knew that I was gay in fourth grade, but I did not come out to my sister until I was 16. And then I didn't come out to my parents until I was 24.
Somewhere in middle school, I think it was like that time when, you know, people started liking girls and, you know, I thought they were attractive, but I just never saw myself being with one long term. I was raised by my father, and so I think parents always kind of know. So I actually came home from college one day, and my dad said, where's your boyfriend? And I said, at home, where's yours? And that was our story.
I more so came out to my mom first. I didn't want to disappoint her. I was like, I have something to tell you. And she goes, you know, what is it, baby? And I say, you know, I was quiet. And then I just started crying. And she says, what's wrong? I said, well, you know, I like girls. She says, it's okay. I never forget that. You know, she rubbed my face and she said, you know, it's okay.
I moved back home, and for the first time I started dating a guy. I went home for the weekend to see my parents, and it was a Sunday evening and I was getting ready to go back to the dorms, and I had a date. My mom asked me, is it with a guy? And I said, yes. And she kind of fell to the ground, started crying. I heard my brother say, Mom, Daniel's gay. He's always been gay. We've always known it. You shouldn't act like this. And my brother came up behind me and he slapped me on the butt and he said, go get him.
My mom would ask me, well, why are all these girls calling the house? Like, why do you have so many girls calling the house and why are they calling this late at night? That was basically that moment where, you know, I realized it wasn't gonna be a secret anymore, you know? And she asked me, you know, straight up, like, are you gay? You know, that's what she asked me. And I couldn't deny it. I told her, yeah, I'm gay.
My family, we kind of had the, you know, don't ask, don't tell policy. My sister-in-law was just like, you know, we're not going to not call it what it is anymore. You know, I don't want my children to be ashamed or to not, you know, be accepting and, you know, you're gay and their aunt is gay. Well, you know, I kind of struggled with it myself, actually, when I was in my teens and in my early 20s. Not really comfortable with, you know, am I really, you know? I had to come into it myself, actually.
My sister, being the rebel that she is of the family, decided to go about herself and directly asked me. She said, do you like boys? My mother found out, and everybody has been very, very supportive. And it's kind of funny how you might be afraid of something until you actually do it.
Mine is a little different because I had kids. As a matter of fact, I had 3 children by the time I was 21. So my story is very different. And it wasn't until I lost my children's father that I decided to just really be myself and who I was. My grandmother raised me, and one of the things she always taught me, she said, you can't be good to anyone else until you're good to yourself. So just be who you are and be the best at it.
People, they see you for who you are, not for what you are privately. You can control your behavior, you just can't change who you really are.
Being gay is just a part of who I am. I'm also a brother, I'm also a son, I'm a friend. I just happen to be a police officer who's gay. Those 3 little words, I am gay, really didn't change who you are.
What matters is, what kind of human being are you? Are you a good human being or are you an awful human being? You know, I consider myself to be a great human being because I care about people.
I was doing well in school, I was doing well in athletics, I went to college, and being gay was just something that, you know, was becoming more accepting, I guess.
If I'm a police officer, I'm me. If I'm gay, I'm me. Military, I'm me.
Don't let other people dictate to you your happiness.
Do it at your own term. Don't let no one rush you into doing it. Just know that you're gonna be loved regardless, and just be strong in your decision.
When you walk in your truth, you walk in your own freedom. When you walk in your own freedom, you're soaring. When you're soaring, no one can hold you down.
Loving yourself is the first step. Once you love yourself, it doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. No one can love you more than you can. The sky's the limit for you, and it will get better.
You just keep your head up, you know, don't let anybody get you down because you just believe in yourself. I'm telling you, it gets better.
It will get better. You will find a career that suits what you want to do, and I'm a sergeant in the police department, doing what I love every day, and I have my own family, and it does get better.
Right now you might feel alone, or there's no one else that knows your story or has never been through what you've been through. That's not the case. There are a lot of us that were right where you are at one time. We felt alone and there's no one else out there. I assure you, I'm an example that it does get better.
Keep your head up, stay encouraged, stay motivated, and you'll change the world. I'm Officer Jason Williams with the Atlanta Police Department, and I'm living proof that it gets better.
I'm SPO Brian Sharp.
And I'm Officer Daniel King.
We're a couple, and we're Atlanta police officers. And it gets better.
I'm SPO Patricia Powell, and it gets better.
My name is Lieutenant Tina Miller, and it does get better.
My name is Officer Anthony Blair, and it does get better.
I'm Sergeant Michael Graham, and it does get better.
I'm Officer Kristen Knight, and it gets better.
I am Officer Danny Lee Harris, and it does get better.
To everyone out there, it gets better.